Hello friends, in the current video we will work out two more problems of the joint venture. We will try to and whereby I will make you understand two more questions whereby it will be easy. See, in accountancy, when you work out more problems, then only you can able to deliver in the examination, right? So we will read the question and we will further proceed. This is a continuation of joint venture video with regards to no separate set of books of accounts are maintained, right? So we'll take up the second question. A and B are entered into a joint venture agreeing to share the profits and losses in proportion of 4/5 and 1/5 respectively. A supplies the goods to the value of 5,000 and expenses incurred are 400. B supplies the good value of 400 and expenses incurred is 300. Sell goods on behalf of the joint venture for ₹12,000, charging commission at 5% of the value realized. In the sense, on sales on this 12,000, the amount due is settled by bank draft. Show necessary accounts in the books of both the parties, right? So we'll prepare the ledger accounts and we'll work out this problem, right? So as you are already aware, we'll divide the paper into two parts basically. Right, so as there are only two partners, right? So we are writing in the books of whom? There are two parties, that is A and B. So in the books of A. So this account is a joint venture account. Place is not sufficient here, so I have written joint venture here. You can understand this is in the books of A, hence this is B's account, right? So like this, we have drawn two accounts and we'll directly do the ledger posting, and I'll show you how to pass the journal entries. Even it is very easy to pass the journal entries, right? Sure. We start. A and B entered into a joint venture. Agreed ratio is 4:1. A supplied the material 5,000, expenses 400. B supplied the material 4,000, expenses 300. Right? So we will post them into the ledger. Right? So as we are doing in the books of A, hence when A supplied the material, we write two purchases. What is the value of material purchases? That is, A supplied worth ₹5,000 and A even incurred the expenditure of ₹400. So to cash, it is the expenditure of A, hence it is cash 400, right? Now B supplied the material worth ₹4,000 and incurred the expenditure of 300. So as we are working out problem in the books of A, now B supplied the material. So to B's account, how much? 4,000 in B's personal account by purchases. 4,000, right? Now B incurred the expenditure of ₹300. So to B's account, so expenditure of 300 in B's account by Sorry. Here I made a mistake. It is not purchases actually. It is joint venture, right? Sorry. So be careful. It should be written joint venture. So by joint venture, expenditure incurred by B is how much? 300, right? So we are writing in the B's personal account. Once the expenditure is done, B supplies the goods, right? B sells the goods on behalf of the joint venture for 12,000. Who is selling? B is selling. Now we are recording in the books of A. So we read by B's account. How much? 12,000. And in B's account we write to joint venture 12,000. Right. Next. Charging commission at the 5% on the value realized. What do you mean by value realized? Here the sale value. So this commission is an expenditure for the joint venture, and who is charging? B is charging. So it will be going to B's personal account, so B's account, 5%, therefore 12,000 into 5% is equals to 10% will be 1200, 5% will be 600, half of which. So in B's account by joint venture 600, clear? So like this we need to post. The amount due is settled by bank draft. So amount is settled by bank draft, clear? Hence, now we need to close this ledger account. Which account? That is joint venture account, ascertain the profit. So as credit side, we have only one value 12,000. We'll find out the summation of debit side. That is 5,000 plus 400 plus 4,000 plus 300 plus 600. So we are getting 10,300 and here we are getting 12,000. So highest value 12,000, we will be recording on both the sides, minus 12,000. Hence we are getting 1,700 as our profit. So which side? This side, 1,700. It will be transferred to P&L account of A and B's account. In which proportion? In the proportion of 4:1. So 17,000 divided by 5. So B will get 340, whereas A will get, so 1700 divided by 5 into 4. So 1360 A will get. Am I right with this calculation? Yes, I hope. So you need to calculate, this is which ratio? The ratio is 4:1. A is getting 4, B is getting 1. So in the ratio of 4:1, the amount comes to 1360 and 340. So in B's account, what we write? By joint venture, the profit will be recorded 340. And this 1360 goes to A's P&L account, right? So once this is done, we need to close this ledger account. So we need to make the summation of credit side. So how much? 4,000 plus 300 plus 600 plus 340. So 5,240. Highest seems to be 12,000 here. So we need to write the value 12,000 both the sides. Now balancing figure is how much? Minus 12,000, we are getting 6,760. So as it is stated in the question, it will be settled by a bank draft by bank. This is the balancing figure receivable from B. What A is writing, that I am going to receive this much of rupees from B. Clear? In the same way, it should be turned in the books of B also. Right? So how to work out in the books of B? That also we will work out, as you are already aware. But still we are working out problems, whereas it won't be a difficulty for you in the examination. Right? So the same way we are writing, we are preparing two ledger accounts. One is joint venture account, another one is, this is in the books of whom? In the books of, place is not sufficient, you are writing in the books of B here. So now it is A's account we need to prepare, right? So same, the as I told you, the values remain same, that is 5,400, 4,000, 300 and 600. These values will remain same when you compare to this, but I am changing the names, that's all. Instead of purchases, as we are preparing the books of B, hence we write whose account? A's account, because this expenditure incurred by A, then to A's account. But in case of B, we are writing two purchases, because B, in the books of B only we are writing, so B is two purchases. To cash this expenditure, to whose account? B's account. Sorry, whose account? Sorry, commission account. Commission account. Commission. So to commission account is 600. Clear? As it is charged by B only. Again, by cash we are selling the material. In the books, B is selling the material, hence it will be 12,000. Clear? Now in the books of A, In the books of A, what we write, by joint venture the purchase value is 5000, by joint venture the expenditure is 400 incurred by A, right? There is no further any amount, right? Now close this joint venture, same profit we will get, that is 1700, that is 12000 both the sides. And 2, earlier we wrote PNL in the, as we were doing in the books of A, A's amount is PNL. Now it is A, now PNL is the B. So here it will be 1360, here it will be 340, already we have divided. So PNL is in the books of B's PNL account, it will go. Now A's amount will come here by joint venture, that is 1360. Clear? Now close the A's account, only one on the debit side, 6760. Right, 6760 to bank, as it is stated in the question, it is settled by the bank draft, hence to bank. How much? 6760 balancing figure. Clear? So like this we need to work out the problem. Now if you are asked to pass the general entries, what will be the general entries? That is joint venture account data to purchases account, joint venture account data to cash account, joint venture account data to B's account, joint venture account data to B's account, joint venture account data to B's account, then B's account data to joint venture. Clear? Then joint venture account data to PNL to B's account. That's all. The final entry for the receipt of the amount, that is bank account data to joint venture. Colors. Like this you can pass the journal. It is quite easy once you prepare the ledger account. Here also the same thing. Clear? Now we'll work out one more question. So it will be easy for you to reproduce because you are about to face the what we call exams, right? So we'll work out one more sum. This seems to be another question, right? See the third question we are working out. A and B entered into a joint venture sharing I'll do little bit fast, you can understand. 3x5, 2x5. A to purchase a timber in Madhya Pradesh and forward it to B in Delhi. Purchase timber worth ₹10,000 and pays 1,000 expenses. B receives the consignment and immediately accepted A's draft for 8,000. So B accepted the bill of A drawn on him. A got it discounted for 7,850. The 150 discount charges should be debited to joint venture as an expenditure. B sold the timber for 16,000. He had to spend 350 for fire insurance and 300 for rent. Under the agreement, he is entitled to a commission of 5% on sale. Right? Very easy. The similar it seems to be. We can easily work out. See, this problem was asked earlier. All the three problems which I did in the previous also. Two problems are BCom Usmani University questions. Right? So as you are aware, we will divide the paper into two parts. Right, so I'll prepare the accounts. This is in the books of A. So this account is joint venture account. This is B's account. Clear? Now similarly we will post them into the ledger, right? So A and B entered into joint venture, they are going to share profit 3:2 ratio. A to purchase timber in Madhya Pradesh and forward it to B in Delhi. A purchased timber worth to be 10,000, pays 1,000. So in the books of A only we are providing, to therefore cash. A purchasing the timber worth rupees how much? 10,000 and expenditure is 1,000. 10,000 and 2 cash, expenditure is 1,000, or collectively you can write, no problem. Once it is done, B received the consignment and immediately accepted a draft for 8,000. Who has accepted? B has accepted. In the sense, A has drawn the bill on B. B accepted the bill. Now is bill with received with whom? A has received, right? So the entry would be bills receivable account data to B's account as B is accepted. So in the books of B, what we will write? By bills receivable 8000 we write as an advance or whatever it may be. So the bills receivable account data to B's account as who has accepted? B is accepted. So in B's account by bills receivable. So the bills receivable will not come into the joint venture as it is not a expenditure. It is just drawn right now. Then this bill is discounted with the banker by A. So we don't write the discounting amount. We don't write the entire amount, but we write only discounting charges. So we treat this discounting charges as an expenditure to the joint venture. So what we will write? This discounting charges, right? So the entry would be bills receivable. How much? 150. 150 being the discount charges, right? So the entry would be bank account data, joint venture account data to bills receivable. In joint venture, we write two bills receivable with the amount of only discount. That is difference between the bill amount and the amount received. That is 150. B sold the timber for 16,000. So B sold, hence by B's account, how much? 16,000. In the B account, what we write? To joint venture, 16,000. Next, he had to spend rupees 350 for fire insurance and 300 for rent. Whose expenditure? B's expenditure. To B's account. Collectively, I am writing, this is how much? 350 and 300. Collectively, 650. 350 plus 300. Clarification sake, I have written here. Under the agreement, he is to entitled commission of 5%. Who has to get? B. So to B's account commission. You can write in bracket also if you wanted to write. 16,000 into what is the percentage is decided? 5% into 5 by 100. 10% is 1600. Half is 800 is the commission, right? And that's all. Nothing is mentioned with regards to the payment. Clear? Now close this account. So this is the commission of B in the B's book by joint venture. 800 is the commission. Now close the joint venture account. Only one value is on 16,000. Therefore, we'll calculate the debit amount. So 11,000 plus 150 plus 650 plus 800. So 12,600 minus 16,000. So we are getting a profit of 3,400. So this is 16,000 both the sides. I am writing the summation. So how much? 3,400 is the profit. To P&L to B's account. What is the ratio? Ratio is already decided. How much? 3 is to 2. 3 by 5, 2 by 5. So divided by 5. So 1360, right? So like this, we need to divide. So now in B's account by joint venture, 1360. Now close the B's account, right? So when you close the B's account, how much total? Debit side total is 16,000 and the credit side is 8,000 plus 800 plus 1360. So 10,160 minus 16,000. We are getting 5,840. So amount is how much? 5,190. Right. So we are not getting the balance actually as per the book, but we might have forgot something. Oh, 650 expenditure we did not write. See, you must complete the double entry at that point itself. To joint venture is 650, right? Therefore, now we'll get the answer. 16,000, and the balancing figure would be 5,190. By, did he say anything regarding the payment? No, he did not. Balance carried down. Clear? So the same question will be worked out in the books of B even, right? So the same way we need to prepare the accounts. Very easy, right? don't worry about the lines that I am drawing, but concept is very important. Once you have the concept, there is no doubt you can easily work out, right? So in the books of B, so this is joint venture account, this is ACE account, right? As I told you, the same values, that is 10,000, 1,000, 150, 650, 800, right? So instead of cash, ACE account to ACE account to who has discounted this? The discounting person is A. Therefore, ACE account even this is bills receivable, right? And to B's account, to cash expenditure incurred by B, hence 650 will be recorded as cash and the 800 will be the 800 will be the commission, so to commission 800, right? So now by cash we are selling the material, now we are B's accountant, there was 16,000. So in A's account what we write? By 10,000, by joint venture 10,000, by joint venture 1,000, by joint venture 150, right? Then next is bill is accepted, right? So when we accepted the bill, what entry we will pass? The entry will be on whose name we have accepted? ACE account data to bills payable. So in ACE account we write to bills payable. How much? 8,000. Clear? So once this is done, we need to close the account. Again, the profit will remain same, as with this total is 16,000. 16,000 profit is 3,400 to ACE account. How much? 2,040 to P&L account, that is 1,360. So now it will goes to B's P&L account. In ACE account we write by joint venture, that is 2,040. Clear? So like this we will post. Now close the ACE account and find out the amount. So this amount is how much? Total is 10,000 plus 1,000, then 150 plus 2,040. Total is 13,190 minus, so this is 13,190 minus 8,000, that is 5,190 to balance carried down. This is the balancing figure, right? So this is the way we need to work out. I hope I tried my best to explain the concept of joint venture first method, second method, when there is no separate set of books of accounts are open, right? Please do subscribe my channel to motivate me to make more qualitative videos with regards to accounting subject is concerned, right? Thank you very much.